Welcome to Department of Electronics and Telecommunication at Vidyalankar Institute of Technology. In this department, we have taken this new initiative to start our own YouTube channel. In this YouTube channel, we are going to upload all our experiments video, value-added course video, or any other important videos. This material will be available to all the students in Mumbai University, and this material will help students to enhance their learning, not just in their classroom, but even outside the classroom. I hope that everyone will like this our effort, and in case of any query, comments, anything, they can put it in comment box. Thank you.
Hello everyone, welcome to Software Simulation Laboratory. Today we are going to perform experiment number 2, titled to study block diagram reduction technique using MATLAB. So now let's first move into some theory. What is block diagram? Block diagram of a control system consists of four components, that is signal, a block with transfer function, summing point, and a takeoff point. The procedure to solve block diagram reduction problems are as shown on the screen. This procedure can be used to solve block diagram reduction manually. Now let us implement this technique using MATLAB. First, let's go to file, start a new script, and write a program over here. Okay, so now we are done with the writing of the program part. So now let us understand the program. First, command CLC stands for clearing the data in the command window. Clear all stands for clearing the objects in the MATLAB workspace. Close all closes all the figure windows. We have written this program for the block diagram by taking the example which is shown on the screen over here. G1 is the first block, G2 is the second block, G3 is the third block, G4 is the fourth block. Correspondingly, these are the transfer functions. S is equal to TF of S defines that S is the transfer function of S. See, likewise, we have defined the transfer function for all the blocks. After that, we have defined the inputs and outputs of all the blocks with the help of the command block diagram name dot input name. So for the first block diagram, we have given the name as G1 and its input name is R, as you can relate from the figure. Its output name is UG1. Likewise, we have named all inputs and outputs of all the blocks. After that, we relate all the inputs and outputs. We have two summing blocks in our example, so we have taken it as sum1 and sum2. Sum block command relates the input and output signals based on their names, that is E, and the first field over here indicates the output, rest all the fields indicates the input, and the last field indicates the sign of the signal, whether it is positive or negative. Here you can see that first is positive and next is negative, which means first input R is positive and Y is negative. This is the corresponding equation, E is equal to R minus Y. Similarly, summing block 2 has output U and input is UG and UG2. You will notice over here that the last field is left blank. This means that both the input are positive. Likewise, U is equal to UG1 plus UG2 will be its equation. Now last step is getting the output transfer function. We have stored this in the variable output TF, and the connect command connects all the blocks and the summing blocks and the input and the output. Input is R and output is YM. It connects all the blocks and summing blocks based on the signal names. So now let's just save it and run it. Now this will return the transfer function in the command window. You can see that this is the corresponding transfer function we have got, which we used to get manually with the help of block diagram reduction technique. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.